13 here, and welcome to the finale episode of Back to the Future, the game. In the last episode, we stopped Edna from burning down the speakeasy, or saloon, or whatever it is. And in the finale, we're going to be stopping Edna from escaping through time. So first, I'm going to sneak under here. And now we're gonna put the, the flux overrides onto this flux emitter right here.
All right.
Nicely done. Now aim the thing toward the receiving dish.
I'll try, but it's getting a little bumpy out here.
So basically, we have to grab onto this thing and aim it at that up there. We have to basically, like, using the D-pad, aim it at the thing. Just like screwing around so I can show you guys what to do. And then once the cursor hovers over, it'll turn yellow. If you hold it to be yellow for long enough, it'll turn green or just disappear. And then it'll be perfectly synced up. Now we just gotta do that two more times.
Great, that's one flux sync down, two to go.
Okay. Now we gotta go around.
Should I disable it?
Leave it alone. It's not a good idea. I'm gonna keep the nuclear reactors.
I get on the rear bumper. Then onto the driver's side. Oh, shoot, I forgot something. Go back up to the front bumper and grab a windshield wiper. Why? Because when we go and try and get up to the driver's side, something's gonna happen and we're gonna need the windshield wiper to save us. So, let's go up there. Okay.
It's locked.
Oh, get off!
No.
Can't sneak past the rearview mirror.
Time to initiate hit mode. Yep, that's helpful. Oh, I gotcha. Gotcha, man. Okay, so now we have to notice when I say try. Try to get to the driver's module from the front. But watch what happens when we do that. Okay, that broke the rearview mirror, but it also opened up Mr. Fusion. So, using that windshield wiper that we just got, we can close Mr. Fusion.
Nice work, Marty.
So now we go to the rear bumper. Driver's side, up to the front,
made it.
Excellent. Now let's get that button right last one before she starts making life difficult.
She's been making it easy up till now.
Now, Let's take the flux emitter on. I mean, not the flux override.
Well, here goes nothing, Doc. Whoa!
Perfect! Now, aim the fluxing towards the receiving dish on my DeLorean.
Receiving dish. Check!
It's the same thing as before. It's just a little bit more difficult. So we just gotta aim it on the cursor. You can see the DeLorean's a little more lively now. Also, the range with this thing is really, really wide. See, the DeLorean's moving around a little bit more. There we go. I don't know exactly how long you have to keep the cursor on it for to make it, like, register, but anyway.
We're almost home, Marty. Just one flux seat left.
Get off my car, you hooligan!
The final flux sink, unfortunately, is on the top of the car.
It's fucked!
Now, we're not gonna be able to get on top of the car without some assistance. So, let's go talk to Edna.
Edna!
What?
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Marty, are you all right?
Not really.
Huh. What?
Pull over.
No.
But now that the window's open, we can reach inside, open the door.
Excellent, Marty. Now that you're on top of the door, you can attach the flux sink to the overhead flux emitter.
Great, Doc.
Right now we take the final flux override. Stick it on top of the flux emitter.
Ha! Nicely done. Now, aim the sink toward the receiving dish.
Okay. This one's gonna be slightly more challenging because we're doing it upside down. It's the same control scheme. Like, the controls aren't adjusted. Like, left is still left, but still. Okay? Plus he moves the... Plus Doc moves the most! In this one... Got it.
That's it! Get out of there, buddy!
Phew.
With the flux sink rises, huh? That's strange.
What?
According to these readings, the temporal cohesion of Edna's DeLorean is decaying at an alarming rate.
English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home. Now! Hold on!
Back. And we're back. Loading screen. Okay, so I think now we watch... Oh, wait a minute. I was about to say we watch about, like, 5-10 minutes of cutscenes at this point, but there's one more piece of dialogue that we get to choose. Because there's one more storyline that we have to wrap up. If this will ever load.
quicker. Then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
No! You can't arrest me! Not now, I just got back from the last century.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. Oh, I'm loving this.
I'll prove it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Stop it! Unhand me, you dolt!
Well, I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
What the hell? Hey, Parker, you're not gonna believe this!
See? What did I say? Ready to go home?
Wait, Doc, the timeline's not fixed yet. Look! Sonny, you missed all the fireworks at the expo. Yeah, so I heard. Listen, I heard a rumor about you two.
Also, they've managed to fix the billboard in 2 months when the courthouse still isn't fixed after 20 freaking years.
I just meet a Reno last night.
Try to keep a secret in Hill Valley.
Well, you're gonna congratulate us or what?
Then it's true. My grandpa's married the wrong grandma. I'm done for.
Hey, are you feeling all right, kid? You don't look so hot.
This just isn't right. Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love.
Isn't he just the sweetest?
Trixie, you can't marry Artie.
Is this about my past with Kid? 'Cause Artie ain't holding that against me.
That's right, darling. The past is the past. Yeah, but... Can you see through me?
Nope, never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin!
What?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotta, did ya?
Don't feel too bad. It was kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute, you're Grandma Sylvie?
Grandma? Hey, how old do you think I am, kiddo? Oh,
but you're so... so skinny and blonde and...
Huh. Yeah, you know, it's amazing.
Oh my god, I've seen you naked. You're... Sylvia?
Huh? You okay, pal?
Yeah, I'm fine. Great. You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around.
Come around to what?
To approving your marriage. You seem kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her. Besides, as my dear old father Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now that I met her, I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aw, thank you, Dad.
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Crockett.
See you in the funny paper, Sonny.
Goodbye, Grandma.
You know, I took some pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
And with that, I think that was the last piece of gameplay that we're gonna get out of this walkthrough. You know, Now, I'll save it for my final credit speech. Now we're back in 1986. I'll let the final cutscene play, and then the credits will roll, and then I'll start talking again.
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
Looks like the estate sale is still going on. Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale? You mean... Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off the family treasures, eh?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Speaking of which, did you find what you were looking for? Yeah, I sure did. Great! Hey, is that a box of Asimov? Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists? Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you. Happy graduation.
Graduation? But that's not for another... The McFlys of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family. From your great-great-grandfather Seamus to the present.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931, to look for her.
Exactly. Who knew she was singing in a speakeasy under her stage name?
This is great, Doc. Thanks.
It's the least I can do for the man who saved me from making the worst mistake of my life.
Yoo-hoo! Dr. Brown!
Edna?
Einie!
What's going on? What are you doing at my door?
The same thing I do every afternoon, silly man. Giving him such much-needed exercise. Isn't that right, Einstein?
Hey, dollface, it's past time for our 3:30.
Coming, sweetie! Oh, Mr. McFly, have you seen my stepson anywhere?
Oh, Biff, I think you're late for an appointment.
Oh, gosh, you're right, Mr. McFly. Hi, Marty.
Don't they make a great little family? You'd never know they met in prison.
Don't say anything. Let's just walk quietly into the lab and hope there are no more surprises.
Future.
Marty, you can't be here. If your younger self sees you, the consequences could be catastrophic.
My younger self? Oh, right. Bring him along, too. This concerns all of us.
What do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes or something?
Nah, we're fine. But our great-great-grandkids?
What the hell?
Great Scott.
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Back to
listen to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you want to save Jennifer and our 12 kids.
What? That timeline was overwritten 5 jumps back.
Doc, Jennifer's how can there be 2 more of me here?
I have no idea. My own rights of space-time continuum should be tearing apart like a cheap dish rag right now.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up. And you gotta come with me to save it. No, me!
So... we meet at last. You've altered my timeline once too often.
What's going on, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands, or three.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real me?
Isn't it obvious, Marty? Come on!
Prepare to be erased.
Doc, wait! What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future? And mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
Where to, Doc?
Mr. McFly, thrill me.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Back to the Future, the game, in its entirety. And now it's time to begin the long ritual of talking about the walkthrough. Back to the Future, the game. This game, in my eyes, is brilliant. It relies on dialogue and humor to basically carry us through the story and pretty darn easy puzzles. Although, to be honest with you, what it turned out to be was a slightly shakier than I think they intended it to be. Christopher Lord is back and ready to voice Dr. Emmett Brown again, and then there's a sound effect that he practically is Michael J. Fox. Come on, guys. Honestly, that pretty much sounded like Michael J. Fox until you actually heard Michael J. Fox. But anyway. And then there's new characters that are introduced that are very colorful. That added with traveling through different hill valleys that really look the same. I can really connect with these characters. Something that the game really does a good job with is making sure that you see the same hill valley, but from a completely different... Making sure that you're seeing the same hill valley town square, but with completely new features every single time. However, this game was made by Telltale, which means that there were several issues. For example, the lip-syncing, I'm pretty sure all of you could tell, never matched up. The animations were very jerky, and the frame rate got choppy a lot. Also, another problem that this game had is that it couldn't decide if it was the next installment in the series or a new Saturday morning cartoon. For example, in episode 1, it started with Marty heartbroken about his best friend abandoning him. And then by episode 3, the game started to break away from reality. The whole Citizen Brown thing and human recreation thing, and then all the fetch quests in episode 4, whatever. Plus, the ending, I get it and everything, but it kind of... Did you see how, they were acting in completely unbelievable and unsatisfying reactions? Anyway, it was a good start, but it could have been better with the ending. The puzzles were enjoyable, and there weren't very... There weren't, main rage challenges. There were no challenges that made me want to quit the game. The only issue is that they were relatively simple. I only got stumped once or twice, and most people look to adventure games for challenge, but this game doesn't have a lot. Okay, so the first few episodes made me feel like this was Back to the Future, Part 4. But... Then, by the time I got to the end credits, I realized that this was an off-the-wall adventure featuring Marty and Doc. But it's not awful, because the game's still funny, clever, enjoyable, and despite all the issues, I love it. I love this game. I love everything about this game, despite the several issues that I've talked about. So I hope you guys can take this into consideration. It's downloadable on the App Store, and it's available for the Wii and PlayStation 3. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to leave a like and a comment and review if you enjoyed. If you enjoyed this series, be sure to click that subscribe button to really something out a ton. And until next time, it's been Gaming Magic 13, signing off, saying hope you have a great day, and I'll catch you guys next time for, I guess, my next walkthrough, which is Portal 2 Co-op. See you guys next time.